This next guy is a columnist for ESPN and Sports Illustrated, also National Lampoon. Let's give it up for Steve Hostetler. Come on, you guys.
Boston! Oh, it's good to be up here, man. I live in Jersey, actually. And don't cheer till you hear the joke. I live in Essex County, New Jersey, which is the county in Jersey with the highest taxes. Here's the problem with that. The taxes pay for things like after-school programs, you know, soccer, Little League, that type of stuff, and I don't have any kids, and I don't give a shit about yours, so I don't really feel I should pay those taxes, so I protested. I did what anyone would in my situation. I marched down to the city councilman's office, and I signed up for Little League, because if I'm gonna pay, I'm gonna play, and I'm hitting 340. Fuck those kids. They are 8 years old. I should be hitting higher than 340. Anyway, Jamie's got a curveball, but then he's on steroids. My point, wouldn't surprise me if Little Leaguers were on steroids. That wouldn't be surprising, right? We wouldn't be surprised at all, because we make the mistake to think that athletes are role models. Here's the problem. Parents are role models. Athletes are athletes. That's all they are. See, I wanted to do steroids when I was a kid. I did. I told my father about it, and he took care of it. I said, Dad, I want to be big like Jose Canseco. And he said, Steve, Jose Canseco is on steroids. I said, so what? He said, that means his balls have shriveled up to the size of teen little raisins. And that was all the parenting I needed. I was 7. I still understood it's better to go to bat with a full 2 scoops. The reason this happens is because we make sports out to be more than they are. Now, I'm a big sports fan, but they're just a diversion. They're a distraction. That's all they are. And I had proof of this when in New Orleans, a couple years ago, when they reopened the Superdome. I don't know if you were following the news, but New Orleans had some issues. And they reopened the Superdome, and it's on Monday Night Football. It's this big deal, and everybody's watching. And every sports writer I read wrote the same thing. They said, if the Saints could only win, what would happen? The Saints won a football game. What would happen? You think the waters would recede? The buildings would be rebuilt? You think that would happen? Because the Saints won the game and nothing changed the next day. But during the game, the sportscaster actually said, the Saints score on the first possession, and the sportscaster actually says, take that, Katrina! Like it's watching the game. Like the Hurricane sitting back there going, man, I had 50 on the Falcons. I have no idea what I'm gonna do. I had no idea the Saints would have such a good running game this year. I mean, they drafted Reggie Bush. I would have thought he would get on to Houston, but they drafted defense. I mean, I don't really follow football. I'm a fucking weather pattern. I like most of you with me on that. Most of you with me. For some of you, that joke struck out like it was Alex Rodriguez in October. I'm just kidding. I'm only kidding. Just the first week of October. He hasn't seen the second in a while. I'll tell you this. This is fun for me. It's so hard to do sports jokes at a comedy club. It's hard to pull off sports jokes because sports fans don't get each other's jokes. Like a basketball fan won't get a hockey joke. And a hockey fan won't get a NASCAR joke. And a NASCAR fan won't get anything. That's unfair. That's unfair. Get lots of stuff. Like fired from the Piggly Wiggly, or pregnant 16, or chlamydia from Uncle Enos. But my point, that's an unfair generalization. I don't know what their uncle's name is. I do like watching sports. My favorite sport to watch on television actually is fairly new. My favorite sport to watch is celebrity poker. I love watching celebrity poker. It is so much fun to watch and try to figure out who the celebrities are. That is a fantastic time. Because I've never heard of any of them. I've never heard of any. It's always like some guy who, you know, was like the migrant worker number 2 on the 4th episode of the unaired 11th season of Falcon Crest, you know? I know, you weren't expecting me to go with a nighttime soap opera reference. I understand. And I didn't know if I should go Falcon Crest or Knott's Landing. I thought it was a Falcon Crest crowd, you know, what with the football jerseys and all. I'll tell you this, I just never heard of any of them, you know? I think there's a better way to introduce those guys. I think they should say, you may remember this guy from last week's episode of Celebrity Poker, because that's the most important thing he's ever done. I have a better way to watch poker. I say we put it in the Olympics. I think that'd be a great time. Make poker an Olympic sport. I think that would be awesome. Well, the currencies wouldn't match up. That'd be hilarious. Watch the French guy lead off the betting with 10,000 euros. Guy from Zimbabwe would be like, I see your 10,000 euros and I raise you this baby. Been great, right? The American would have to match it though, right? We'd have to match it. The American would be like, well, I see your 10,000 euros. That's only 2 grand over here. What? 12? We're fucked. But an African baby, that's just the price of a cup of coffee per day. Takes a second, but it's gold. Then it comes over the Saudi Arabian, right? Saudi Arabian's gotta be tough, right? He's all badass. He's like, well, 10,000 euros, I see that. I see your baby, I see your egomaniacal foreign policy, and I raise you everything in my pocket. The American's like, sweet, all my politicians. So then everybody's in, right? Everyone's in. Everyone's in. It's this tense moment, you know, everybody's in. Well, except the French guy, he folds, but everybody else is in. And it comes over the guy from Zimbabwe, he gets disqualified because he had to eat the king of spades, and you can't do that. The guy from Saudi Arabia gets disqualified because he is the king of spades, and comes over to the American, he throws down his cards, he's like, full house, bitches, and everybody looks, and it's a pair of threes. They're like, dude, you said you had a full house. He's like, I know, I thought I would get one if I played long enough. You know, the in case I didn't, I figured the government would just bail me out. Thought that would help. And that is the problem with sports in this country. That's the problem with Plaxico, that's the problem with Michael Vick, that is the problem with everyone, because we have no personal responsibility in this country, and I don't know if we ever will. And I knew that watching Daryl Strawberry. That was the moment that I gave up, because I watched Daryl Strawberry call his cocaine addiction a disease. Cocaine is not a disease, it is a problem. Herpes is a disease. Because no one willingly tries herpes for the first time. It has never happened, and it never will. There will never be anyone going, you know, I don't want full-blown herpes, I just want to have some at parties. Is that, could I just get a few herpes? Let me just get a few, let me get one herpes, come on. I didn't mean to ask you specifically, sir, that got awkward. Thank you for listening, Boston, have a good night.
I got game, she got game, we got game, they got game, we got game. It might feel good, it might sound a little something, but fuck the game if it ain't saying nothing.